Steady growth is the centerpiece of the entire global economy. Everyone talks about growth. It's the centerpiece of the U.S. economy. The earth is overpopulated, and that's the first thing that we have to educate people about. We've got to educate people that growth is a dead end. There's a cliff out there, and you're headed toward the top of the cliff. We've got to understand the arithmetic of growth and the consequences of it. I came to Boulder in 1950. To join the faculty of the Department of Physics of the University of Colorado. I got to thinking about the fact that people really didn't understand the arithmetic of steady growth. So I put together a talk. I first gave it in September of 1969 on the arithmetic of growth, and I have since given that about 1,690 times. There's an example that I use in the talk, and this is the example of bacteria in a bottle. And you presume you have bacteria that double in number this way every minute. Now that's the characteristic of steady growth, doubling in a fixed length of time. And you put one of these bacteria in an empty bottle at 11 in the morning, and then you observe that the bottle's full at 12 noon. So the first question to ask is, well, when was the bottle half full? And the answer is 1 minute before 12, because they double in number every minute. And the second question to ask is, well, if you were an average bacterium in that bottle, at what time would you first realize that you were running out of space? Well, you know, 1 or 2 minutes before 12 if you're really observing. And now the third question to ask is, well, suppose some of the bacteria realize that they're running out of space, so they launch a great search for new bottles, and they find 3 new bottles. Now that's a colossal discovery. They now have 4 bottles. Before they discover there's only 1. Now surely this will give them a sustainable society, won't it? Well, at 12 noon, 1 bottle's filled, 3 to go. 1 minute after 12, 2 bottles are filled, there are 2 to go. And at 2 minutes after 12, all 4 are filled, and that's the end of the line. And that's all the arithmetic you need to be able to evaluate these really unbelievable statements that you have from people in high places who say we'll discover new resources, all that we need to meet the requirements of the growth. There will be limits, and as we approach these limits, things become very difficult. And we're approaching it now globally in petroleum. People say, well, you know, all this new high tech and drilling for oil and drilling for natural gas, that'll enlarge our supplies. Well, no, it doesn't. It doesn't change the amount of natural gas or oil that's in the ground. What it does is let us use it up more rapidly. So technology lets us speed up the depletion of these resources. The United States today is not sustainable. We can prove that. Right now we're importing something like two-thirds of the petroleum we consume. We're importing something like 20% of the natural gas that we consume. The world population now, the rate of growth is declining, but the United Nations projections still say that the population will continue to grow till, they guess, around 2050, maybe 40 years from now, and that at that time, the population will have grown from its present number, which is about 7 billion people. It will have grown to, they estimate, anywhere from 9 to 13 billion people. Lots of well-meaning people will look at population growth rates in underdeveloped countries, for instance, of 3 or 4% a year, and they'll point to those people and say, oh, they're the problem over in some distant place, so we don't have to think about it anymore. The worst problem of population is in the United States because of our very high per capita demand for energy and resources. The average child born in the United States will, in that child's lifetime, have 10 or 20 times the impact on world resources compared to a child born in an underdeveloped nation. So we've got to address the problem at home. And what we've got to do is to educate people about the problem and to recognize that we have to live within our means. We're not doing that now. Global warming is changing the climate of the Earth. If any fraction of the global warming can be attributed to the action of humans, that's all the proof you need to say the human population today is greater than the carrying capacity of the Earth. People don't realize how fast things can grow, even at 1% per year. That means doubling in 70 years. Well, 70 years is like a human lifetime. When I was growing up, the first number I learned in school was 120 million. That was the population of the United States. Now it's 300 million. The United States population now is growing something like 1% per year. Doesn't sound like much. That means instead of 300 million now, we'll have 600 million. And so if we're going to have a sustainable society for our children and for our grandchildren, let's discuss nationwide how large a population do we think we should have in the United States? You cannot sustain population growth. You cannot sustain growth in the rates of consumption of resources. Period. It's not debatable. It's based on arithmetic. It's not debatable unless you want to debate arithmetic.